No, it doesn't taste very good by itself because it's not sweet. Okay, you can pour it in the pot.
Okay,
you can. Day four of Vlogmas. We got up this morning and did the whole breakfast thing and hot chocolate and all that stuff. And I got ready and I'm about to make the trek to the attic. So you guys saw we decorated the tree at church and our tree is up and just has lights on it. For the tree at church, we needed another tree topper. And at first we were thinking a bow and we weren't really sure, you know, what we wanted to go with. I found a star that I liked at Target that sort of matched the theme of the tree. I'll put a picture of it over here. So I had looked at our local Walmarts. I couldn't find the lights that I needed. And I looked on Amazon. I couldn't find the lights I needed, but Target had them. But Target is sort of out of the way for us, and I didn't want to have to pay for shipping. So I checked out with both of them together, and then that way I got free shipping, and then the church will reimburse me for the star, and it's just a win-win situation. So that was a good thing for the morning. I am going to go ahead and start decorating the tree today. We spent yesterday doing a lot of the main house decor and did some stuff in the kids' room and in the living room. It usually takes me a couple days anyway, but having a 3-year-old and a 1-year-old, it definitely makes it more challenging. Andy has become the eater of all red berries, and my decor is pretty neutral as far as Christmas goes. I have a lot of natural wood. I have mercury glass. I have lots of like greenery. I don't have a lot of color. And so the way that I've brought in some color is with red berries. And so I went ahead and took all of my strands of red berries and put them in a separate container to get them away from her. But I didn't realize that the little tree that's in our bedroom here and then the garlands that I have in the living room have red berries already woven into them. So to a certain extent, it's just going to have to be us teaching her and her learning that you can't put these in your mouth. But she, I think in her mind, she thinks they're like a berry, they're a fruit. And so that has been a little bit of a challenge. But I'm about to make the trek to the attic now. Brandon brought down part of the ornaments, but he didn't bring down all of them. So I'm going to go get the rest of the ornaments and then I'm going to take all these back up. I'm honestly a little sad to take them back up just because I love fall so much and I love all of these sweet books. But I think that we read all of them, to be honest. I think we really read all of our fall books. This one was a little bit long. Even I like kind of got a little bored reading it just because it's so wordy. And some of the wording of Winnie the Pooh gets you kind of tongue-tied, or at least it does for me. So we tried reading this one day as like our preschool reading of the day, and it didn't really go over so well. But all the rest of these have been big hits. But I'm going to take them up there and bring down the ornaments, and then I'll also bring down our Christmas books. It's pretty cold outside. I'm not super excited about my trek up to the attic, but I'm going to wear my jacket and just make it as quick as possible. And then we are going to decorate this tree. Today is just a laid back day at home. We don't have anything planned other than I have a guitar lesson this evening. But I'm thankful after the past couple days getting up early and taking the kids so that I could be back here for my photography lessons. I'm thankful to just have a day where we're not going anywhere, not doing anything, and maybe we can get most of the Christmas stuff knocked out of the way. I've never really been a decorating for Christmas before Thanksgiving person, but pretty much as soon as Thanksgiving's over, I like to have it up as soon as possible just so I can enjoy it. I really don't like the thought of finally getting it the way I want it and then I have to take it down. So my goal is just by the end of the week to have it the way that I want it. I think that's a pretty reasonable and achievable goal. So I'm gonna head to the attic.
How are your kids doing, huh? Good.
Alright, we are sitting down to lunch now after spending some time decorating the tree this morning. We're having some leftover chicken chili from supper last night, and then I'm also having that chopped sunflower seed salad from Aldi, and I put some chicken on it because I didn't use all of that pack of chicken tenderloin yesterday to make the chili, so I put it in here, and that's about it. So it's 3 o'clock now, or somewhere around there. Nap time just ended, and I was editing my video for Vlogtober day two. Not Vlogtober, Vlogmas. This is not October. And a lot of my shots of me talking were not in focus. So it honestly got me a little bit frustrated, and I actually just had to step away from editing for a little bit and do something else, because you know, it's just like you do this footage and you, like, you're looking at your little viewfinder flip out screen and you think that you're in focus, and then you look back and you're actually not, and it's super frustrating. So I put a little disclaimer just, you know, to please have patience with me, and I'm still learning. There's all different settings as far as, you know, you can have it just focus on a single point, or you can have it tracking, and I'm pretty sure I had it on tracking. Maybe that's not the right thing to do. I'm not sure. Couple monkeys coming in the door. So, we just worked a lot this morning on decorating the tree in the living room, and now I'm going to turn my attention to this little tree in our room. This was a $5 thrifted find last year, and, I'll show you the ornaments that I have, and I've got a couple new things to add this year to it. So this is what we're working with. Here's our glamorous life. So this is what we are working on for this tree. Some of these were from last year, and some are new. So actually the first vlog that I did ever was last December, and it included decorating this tree in our room. So this tree was a thrifted find, and I just really love it. I put thrifted lights on it, and I plan, if you watched my last yard sale haul, I plan to make that basket into a little tree collar. We'll see if I'm successful in that. Sorry if it's a little noisy. The boys are playing ball and wrestling. But so these are the elements that I want to use to decorate the tree. These were for my $5 Goodwill challenge last year that Hillary from Old World Home does. So I found them for a quarter a piece at a thrift store, and immediately I just thought they were so cool and so unique. And so I went back and bought all that they had, and I stained them and put these little hooks in the top, and I'm really pleased with how they came out. So most of them, some of them have evidently lost their tie, or maybe I never put it in there in the first place, but most of them have a little loop here that I can hang them from. And then in addition to that, I have some faux olive branches and some faux eucalyptus. Those did come from Hobby Lobby, I think, last year. And then these are old. They were thrifted, and I don't remember how much they were, but they can't have been very much. And then these are a new addition this year. I've featured those in a couple pictures on my Instagram just because I really love them. And they didn't have a price tag. I got them out of the Christmas area in our local thrift store, and I brought them to the front, and I said, how much are these? And they said, oh, a quarter. And I was like, okay, definitely. So I love all these elements. I don't love that these are breakable, especially with Andy, so these may have to go up a little bit higher on the tree. So I just finished up my guitar lesson, and Brandon actually helped me get supper going so that it doesn't take so long. We are making this kind of sheet pan, Mexican-inspired thing. I've made this before. I still haven't bought a new vegetable peeler, so I peeled the butternut squash with a butcher knife. I don't recommend it. It was not fun. But anyway, this is what it looks like. So it's going to go in the oven at 450, and cook for a little while. And then I've got the rice cooker over here, and I will just put some water in it. The rice is already in it, ready to go. And then I'm going to make some guacamole, and that's going to be supper, and that's going to be my supper tomorrow too, probably. So here is the tree. I don't know if I'll add any more to it, but right now that's what it looks like. And like I said, hopefully I'll be able to cut a hole in the top of that basket and slip it right under the tree. I'll have to take the... I see you. I'll have to unscrew the base down here so that I can make that happen. But here is the tree. I love this tree. I just think that the details are so pretty. I think that the ornaments and the texture is the biggest thing on this tree, I think. So here's a question. I had thought about removing that framed artwork on the wall. Those are two watercolor things that I had done in the past. But now that I'm seeing it, I really like the way that the light reflects off the glass. So I think I'm gonna keep it. What do you guys think? I think that it looks really pretty. And I've even considered doing some different artwork that's a little more Christmassy that I did for Andy whenever I was pregnant with her. And then this I also did. I kind of got into watercolors whenever I was pregnant with her. I haven't done it a lot since then. Anyway, let me know what you guys think because I really like it. Supper was delicious, and there are my leftovers. So that way I can eat this during my supper break when I am teaching lessons tomorrow. So kids are in bed. We had a really, really delicious supper. And like I said, I have leftovers for tomorrow, which is great because Thursdays are always very busy and I don't have time to make a meal. So I am just going to sign off here and go finish editing because I didn't get to do that. And I just love that sparkle. Makes me happy. So I am going to go finish editing and maybe have a little snack. And then I'm going to go to bed. So I will see you guys tomorrow.